Hello. We're going to do another visual novel that sounds quite interesting. There were references to Twin Peaks in it, so I'm intrigued. What's it called, Bill?
It's called Hitchhiker and it's available free at the moment on Humble Bundle. You just Google Humble Bundle Hitchhiker, you should be able to find it.
Yes. Here we are. Fastest.
That's nice, isn't it?
Pardon?
That's nice, isn't it? Unity's always good.
Big letters, they're good. You like big
Unity's,
letters, don't you? That's
yeah.
very loud. Mad about pandas.
That's pretty good as well.
Well, I do like pandas, but also, to be fair, I feel like they should put
Die?
in some effort.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they shouldn't be there, should they?
Well, they've had their chance. Oh, look, a little thing. Am I supposed to do anything?
Think you can
It's
move.
quite soothing, this. It's
No.
like a driving simulator.
Yeah.
And
I
I
think you
can't
can move
drive,
around.
so.
I think you can look around.
Oh, really?
Think click and drag, maybe. There you go.
Don't
You
trust unknown drivers.
can hold down and drag, sorry. Hold down the
So, where are you headed?
Oh, I don't have to do any reading. Shrugs.
Not the talkative type, eh?
No.
That's okay. Most people I pick up are just waiting for their turn to talk. Want to raise them? They're from my farm.
Sure, thanks. Raisins have farmers. Well, yeah, where do you think they come from?
Yeah.
Oh, right. Raisins have farm. Did I pick one? Oh.
You ate a raisin. You gotta look around.
You don't look so good.
That's what happens
Yes, I
when I look
see you're
around.
worried. Strange. The Thompson seedlings, good raisins. We still farm more of those in California than we are on Earth.
Hello?
You want to know the clearest evidence that reality isn't real?
Go on then. Oh, wouldn't I be sarcastic?
Raisins and grapes, man. They're the same thing, but they taste disgusting when eaten together. Obvious bug in the program there, right? Memory is a slippery thing. Think about when somebody asks you about this ride, assuming you even know where you're going, and get someplace where somebody can ask you, "Hey, how'd you get here anyway?" They'll ask you, "Oh, I hitched." And your brain will flash back for a second when you say this, and it'll show you a frozen snapshot of yourself sitting in this car talking to me like we are right now. But which moment will it actually show you? Will it be this one? Or this one? Or this one? We think we remember how people really were, how our lives together really were. But when we think back to them, even the people we cared about the most, all we're doing is snatching moments out of the air, just grabbing another raisin out of the box.
You all right, mate? What is it with you? Somebody in particular?
Yeah, my wife. She's dead now. But you probably guessed that.
No. Actually, I want to know, how would I guess?
It's one to know one, right?
How do
I can always spot someone who's grieving along this highway. They usually stand on the road with a dazed look on their face and their thumb up in the air.
You read out the things, my responses.
Do I know you from somewhere?
No, I don't know you, kid. I just know the type.
Okay.
Hey, do me a favor and crack the window, would you?
I'll try.
Hold that too much hope.
Hey, kid, how about opening that window?
I'm trying.
What you got there?
I don't know. Oh, don't mention the phone number. Oh, just...
Just a matchbook, huh? I figured it must have been something important.
Why? Say nothing. Why?
Because the window is still closed.
Oh. What?
That's better. Now, where were we?
You pick up a lot of hitchhikers. Where are we headed anyway? I want to know.
Yeah, a fair number. But after a while, you start seeing the same few archetypes over and over. You got the numbnuts Kerouac fans. You got your autodidact blowhards. They'll talk your ear off. You got a lot of people from Cincinnati for some reason. You got your deadheads trying to get to some concert someplace. Then there's the water bottle person. Always worrying they're going to run out of water before they get where we're going. Still, you're the first hitcher I ever picked up who doesn't have a destination. Copernicus.
Copernicus? Copernicus is very funny, pretend to be from Cincinnati.
Seems like the right name for a guy who's traveling the world without knowing where he's going. You just sit back, Copernicus, and invent a language where false statements are impossible.
Actually, that was Comenius. What language?
Copernicus. He tried to invent this language where false statements... never mind.
Choked on my D again, BB.
Oh,
you know, when I was a kid, my brother and I used to drive our parents crazy on long drives together. Our folks wouldn't let us listen to the radio in the car. So we used to make up these songs about food on long drives to pass the time. We had this one with about 30 verses, each about a different kind of grain.
Sounds thrilling.
There was this one time we passed a billboard for some kind of bread, challah bread. In hell they have a hell of a lot of challah bread. In hell they have a hell of a lot of challah bread.
Let me out.
Yeah, drove mom and dad crazy. In hell they have a hell of a lot of challah bread. In hell they have a hell of a lot of challah bread.
I've got about enough.
Come on, join in. In hell they have
I'm outside.
Yeah.
In hell they have a hell of a lot of challah bread.
You're just making it more like a film, you know?
No. No. Metaphysical.
Actually, I'm beginning to understand my parents' perspective. Getting older is funny. It's like reading a book where less and less happens, but the writing gets better and better.
That's profound. I'll take more action and worse writing.
Profound. Thanks. I got it from an app. It's this app with philosophical sayings. My wife got it for me to make me sound smarter.
It like being married? Did she work on the farm?
Yeah. We used to have a strict division of labor back when we worked together. She would raise the grape from the time it appeared on the vine. I'd step in as soon as it was time to start drying them. Our customers used to have fun with that. I'm the dry one, they'd say. Grapes attract a certain kind of person. A person who likes to make jokes. Wine enthusiasts, tourists, people who like to talk.
Dancing.
If I'm totally honest with you, I don't really remember what she looked like. Remember everything about her, just not her face. Some people have faces that are easy to remember. Doesn't seem fair. You think you're present in the moment, Copernicus? You've been talking to me for 10 minutes. What colour are my eyes?
Blue, brown, green, grey. Blue.
Nope.
Oh.
Like I said when I picked you up, some people are just waiting until it's their turn to talk. Anyway, pop open the glove box and I'll show you a photo of my wife.
Well, I just don't have a very good memory. It's not anything to do with not listening. She looks like a beach.
Hey, where'd you get that? That's not her. And that guy there, he looks like you.
I was just going to say, I bet that's me. Who's the woman? What's this doing in your car?
I don't know. I was going to ask you the same question, Copernicus.
Okay.
Well, I guess it belongs to you. You better hold on to it.
Bales of hay in a car.
Yes.
Wonder where.
Want to hear a joke?
Sure.
Why did the raisin take the prune to the dance?
Because
he couldn't get a date.
Why didn't I see that?
Hey, that reminds me. It's almost 4:30. You'll like this. It's my favorite. I once knew the hostess, Darlene. She used to change the tires on my truck on Highway 51.
Welcome to another Interstate Riddle Hour. Here's our first riddle. Keep your eyes filled, all you blacktop carpet baggers.
This is good.
I fly, yet I have no wings. I cry, yet I have no eyes. Darkness follows me. Lower light, I never see.
What am I? Find me and click. Why am I find me and click? Or is it the sun?
Here's a hint. We're looking for something fluffy.
Oh, clouds! No.
Oh, look in the
clouds. It's a cloud.
That thing that comes there.
Wake up! Oh my god! Oh. And fluffy and low on the horizon.
Fluffy and low.
Wake up. It says wake up. Go away.
Very good.
Clouds.
A gatekeeper for the bound. It opens and shuts with a similar sound.
A gate.
What was the clue?
A gatekeeper forever bound. He opens and shuts with a similar sound.
Yeah, okay.
I would say a gate.
Think metal piece that open and shut.
Well, I can't see a gate though.
The window?
No, that's not got metal teeth.
Metal teeth?
Yeah. Final hint, the answer is sitting between your feet.
Ready? Here's one more. He lies without touching the ground.
He lies without touching the ground.
Ready for a hint? I never did like changing the tires. The fine liar.
Oh. This is really stressful, I don't like it. Someone in the car is lying to you and it isn't me. Someone in this car is lying to you and
it
isn't me.
Damn it, darling. I should have tipped her better when she changed the tires. She's been out to get me ever since.
What are you lying about?
Look, I admit I lied. But only about one thing.
Not far from my wife, you said. We've never met before. I never put that photo in. We never met.
Yeah. I recognized you right away on the side of the road. Knew right away you're the guy who took photos of me in my trailer for that magazine.
Turn the radio on. Wait, when? Radio.
Relapse is now ended. I helped you like this time.
You showed up at my trailer park, taking photos. At first, I was a bit suspicious, since there were plans to kick us out and develop the trailer park into some kind of shopping center. But then it became clear that you'd been sent here by a magazine to do one of those stories about vanishing farmers that always pulls heartstrings with the rest of the country.
Not the vegans. Was she there with me? Why did you lie to me?
Let's not kid ourselves. You don't seem like a guy who wants to know.
What do you mean?
Don't forget, you picked this car every bit as much as I chose to stop for you. You picked this car, picked me, not to feel anything.
I trusted you not to feel what?
You see what I mean? I'm one of the good guys here.
Look at back seat. Who the hell is that in the back seat? No one there.
You never mentioned anything about him, but I guess he's part of what you're running from.
Am I dead? What's this all about? Just what's this all about?
Here. I'll try to explain.
This is a dream of you sleeping.
You are also dead.
This is a dream and you are weeping.
Well then. Oh.
That was. Oh.
Travels along a road until he reaches a gate at the top of a hill. The road has been long and straight so far, and the going has been easy. But now the man can't go any further, so he takes a seat by the road to rest. The man waits, and after a length of time that seems neither short nor long, the gate opens, and a guard appears. The man asks the guard for entry, but the guard says he cannot let him enter at the moment. The man thinks for a second and asks if he will be allowed through later. It is possible, says the guard, but not now. The gate now stands slightly open, and the man tries to look through it longingly. His journey has been easy so far, and he misses the feeling of the open road. The guard notices and laughs. Even if you could gain entry, there are many gatekeepers after me. Some are much stronger than me, and I'm afraid to look upon them. So there the man waits, for days, months, years, waiting to enter. One day, when he's given up hope of entering, a single question occurs to him. One he has not thought of before. Why, he wonders aloud, are there no other travelers at this gate? Early in my journey, the road was crowded with them, and yet, in all these years, no one but myself has waited in front of this gate. The man is surprised to hear an answer come from a voice next to his ear. It is you who made this gate, says a bird perched by his shoulder. So it exists for no one but you. But why? Asks the traveler. Why would I want to stop here? The bird replies, after hungrily eating a crust of bread from the man's hand. After this point, the road becomes less straight. It becomes like the tree in which I live, splitting into dozens, hundreds of branches. The path becomes impossibly narrow and frail, and crowded with the view of other paths one could have taken. There's only one point ahead on the road where all paths converge, where all points join, where the light shines through skin and through lies. But it's never been reached by one of your kind, a traveler who walks on feet. "Shoo!" cries the guard, chasing the bird away. "Don't listen to his nonsense." Having said this, he takes a seat next to the traveler, but not before closing the gate forever. So when you think about it, who knows how long we've been sitting here, just like this, on this road. Take it from me. It's better to face things with, what's it called again? Fortitude. Better not to feel too much.
Okay.
Want a raisin?
No.
You sure? Just need to get used to it. Life is like a box of raisins.
Oh, no.
That's some Forrest Gump type wisdom for you right there. Here, I'll leave the box open for you. Help yourself.
Billboards had, like, something very un-billboardy on it.
What did it have on it?
Something about love. Something. Eat raisin, throw raisin out the window. I might as well just be weird.
You don't want to do that. There's no telling what those birds will do once they start swarming.
Ooh, swarming birdies. First may swarm. Sorry, raising out window.
I told you not to do that.
You're making a mistake, kid. You don't know where they're taking you.
Oh,
I'll help you.
I wonder if they're from hell.
I'll help you figure out what happened when she came back from Europe.
No way, you lied. Okay, I'll trust you. Okay.
All right, well, I wasn't planning on going this way. But since I see how you feel, I'll take you to the local mystery spot.
The what? Hey, this wasn't the deal. The what?
I think the local mystery spot is exactly what the doctor ordered. There's a special camera there, located in a shed set back a ways from the boardwalk. It takes a picture of whatever's inside you. I can't think of a better way to help someone who can't remember anything important. It's only a few minutes away. In fact, we might be close enough already. Better check your backpack, Copernicus. Sometimes it does its thing way before you expect to be in range. That's not a good look for either of you. I guess you'll be needing to get to the bottom of that. Just remember, there are many more gates ahead and many more guards. I'm pretty much the friendly drunken uncle of the bunch. Well, good luck to you, kid. Oh, one more thing.
What is it? More advice?
What did the grape say when he got run over by a car?
Something about a date. No idea.
Nothing. He just gave a little whine. Good luck with your search.
Thanks for playing. Oh. What? Okay. Oh, that's that.
That's that.
That was... Probably supposed to go back into it, but I'm not going to now. Just check that nothing else is meant to happen.
No, I think that's the What did you think?
Well, I'm definitely interested. You're obviously meant to go back into it and try something else, but I'll do that another time.
I think there's going to be more from Reem. I think that's like one instalment, and then I think they'll do different ones.
Okay, well, Hitchhiker. Is it Hitchhiker?
Yeah, Hitchhiker.
Yeah. There you go.
There you go.
Goodbye.